Welcome, boys and girls, to week 11, kinder through second grade workout with Coach W. Glad to have you back. I hope everything's going good. This week, we're going to go back to the chair stretches to help you guys that are sitting a lot and having to do your work from a chair and stuff. So let's begin again with the chair stretch, the seated chair twist, okay? The seated chair twist. Number one, so you try to have your back nice and tall, and then you turn and grab this right here, and then you turn and twist, okay? And we're going to count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, as you're counting, let me tell you, this helps to stretch the back and spine, as well as your internal and external obliques. That helps you twist. It also helps your lats. These are your muscles here, your latissimus dorsi muscles. All right, it does stretch the pecs because I'm pulling, and then my biceps because I'm pulling myself this way as well. The shoulders and the deltoid because I'm pulling too. So every time that you're pulling, you're stretching all these different muscles. So now I turn back this way, and because I'm pulling again, I'm pulling, stretching the deltoid, I'm pulling with my bicep, I'm twisting the back right here, the muscles and the spine. And then my lat muscles, and then the deltoid, and all the muscles of my core, and the oblique muscles. So it's a good stretch to do, and make sure you turn your head with it, all right? So you get a nice, good stretch going around both sides, all right? So that feels good for the back. Again, that's the seated chair twist, all right? Next up, we're gonna do our ankle to knee pose, okay? Now remember, ankle goes to the knee. See, angle to the knee. Okay, so the main thing you're doing here is grab the underside of your leg and then you're pushing this part down. This is stretching the joint right here. So you're feeling the joint in your ball and socket joint of the hip. So stretching the hip, and the muscles are all around the hip right here. And so it stretches the glutes right there, and it stretches a little bit of the quads and the hamstring. And it also stretches the the ligaments and between your femur and your pelvis. The femur is the biggest bone in your body. That's the bone right here. And then your pelvis, that's your hip bone. So as you feel this right here, you're pushing down right here. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Feels a good stretch there. All right, again, so the ankle, you bring your ankle to the knee. That's all you're doing there. And then I'm pushing this side down. Feel a good stretch right here in the hip. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So you should get a nice stretch in the hip joint right here. Okay. All right. Next up now is going to be the neck. All right. So you have a neck muscle called the the sternonecloid, okay, the sternonecloid mastoid muscle, which is right here, plus then you have your trapezius muscles here, and then all the mother muscles around surrounding your neck and bone. So then the cervical joints, which is the cervical neck bones. All right, so we'll do the neck stretch. So to the side gently, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm stretching these muscles here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then now pull the bird. And I feel this pulling all the muscles in my spine too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And again, I'm just being gentle and feeling it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again, you don't want to stretch it to the back. You can lift up, but you don't want to pull back, okay? There's no need to do that. That can hurt your neck. All right. Next up is going to be the reach for the stars pose, all right? This stretches their shoulders, your spine, and your lats down here, all sorts of different parts, your wrists, your fingers, the biceps. All right, so remember, put your fingers interlaced, flip them around, and reach all the way up, and this stretches right here in my neck and my shoulders. Hold it up straight. Sit up straight when you do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. and gently lean to the side. Now I really feel the pull on this side over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I go to this side, and now I feel it on this side of my body. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Your latissimus dorsi muscles run right here. These help you pull. You're pulling down something. That's these muscles here. All right, very good. Again, that's the reach for the stars pose. All right, next up now is the overhead shoulder stretch. Remember, this works the deltoid muscle, but like the medial head, which means it's closest to you, so it's upper part here, and then also the lateral head of the triceps, and the medial head of the triceps, and part of the biceps, so, and then even part of the lats too. So up and behind, like you're trying to scratch behind your back, and grab the elbow and push it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Very good. And then I would switch. Try to reach down low and grab the elbow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Very good. All right. So that's the overhead shoulder stretch. Now we're going to do the posterior shoulder stretch, or this one we call it the shoulder pull. So again, stretches the deltoid muscle and part of the back of your tricep too. All right, so stick your arm out, pull it across, pull the elbow towards you so it's straight across. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There you go. Other arm switch. So hold it out in front, just bring it straight across, then grab the elbow and pull it in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Call that the shoulder pull or the posterior shoulder stretch. All right, and last one for this one, you get up, and then this is the hamstring stretch. All right, so I'm using the chair. I just put my heel down, grab for my toes. Now I feel it back here, and then if I want more, I can bend the knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. That feels good because I feel a good stretch back here. And I'll switch right here. Grab the toes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There we go. All right, I think we'll be done with the chair for now. Okay, moving right along. Now we'll get on to the warm-up exercises. All right, so first off, is the high knee running in place? All right, so we'll try for 30 seconds, boys and girls. So put your hands out in front and try to get your knees up as high as you can. And again, we stand the balls of our feet. Try not to let your heels touch the ground. All right, try for 30 seconds. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. There we go. We just did 30 seconds of high knee running in place. All right, so the high knee running in place, again, when you're staying on your toes, that strengthens your calf muscles really, really good. So you get nice strong calf muscles to help you jump and run higher. Plus, since the cardio workout, you're building up your heart because it gets heart pumping. And then as you breathe harder and breathe in more, it raises your blood oxygen levels, which also strengthens your lungs, okay? So next up now is we're gonna do the trunk twist, all right? So we did the seated chair twist, so I decided we'll also do the trunk twist, all right? So we'll put our hands out, and then we'll do the trunk twist, and we turn our head along with our trunk, all right? So feet apart, and we stay back straight, and as we turn our head with it. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. As I'm doing this, I feel my back, my spine, stretching, which is good. But then as I'm pulling my shoulder, I'm stretching my shoulder too and my chest muscle. See, I'm pulling it back. I'm pulling it back each time as I'm going. And when I turn my head though, and my neck, that's important, because you don't want to strain your neck on this. So if you turn your body, you turn your head with it. If you try to keep your head straight forward, you're just gonna hurt your neck. All right, here we go. That's enough of those. That's good. Trunk twist, okay? All right, next up, we're gonna do our arm circles. Yes, we love our arm circles. All right, so with the big arm circles, you know, you're strengthening all the shoulder joint. This is one of the most complicated joints in your body. It's called a ball and socket joint. You have this rotator cuff, which holds all the different muscles together and ligaments and tendons to keep your arm in. And then you have the deltoid and the tricep that connects and the bicep that connects and holds everything together. And then the triceps, which is up here, which is part of your back going up into your neck. Everything converges to hold it together. So as you're doing these arm circles, you're loosening it all up really good. Plus then you're actually strengthening it, all right? So we'll start off with the big arm circles forward. So remember, start with your hands up and lean down to go forward. And remember, you have to go out to the side so you don't bend the elbows. Really, really easy. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. There we go. All right. Nice and easy. Now backwards, remember, when you go backwards, you lift up and go down to the side. See, that way you don't have to bend the elbows, see? All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold your head up nice and straight. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, the whirly bird, 17, 18, 19, and 20. There we go. All right, now the little arm circles. Now this one's the best one for giving the actual strength training. Builds the muscles, the trapezius muscles here, top of the deltoids, and the bicep and tricep all right here. This is the best one. Your arms have weight all their own. So this is just like lifting weights, just by having your arms here. So then when we add a little bit of the movement of the circles, now you're strengthening it more. So here we go, forward ones, little ones, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And hold them up. I know it burns, but keep them up. You can be strong. The longer you hold them, the stronger you're gonna be. Okay, backwards. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, up and down a little bit, but don't let them go down. You can go up. You're squeezing the muscles in your neck. Squeeze them. That's the trapezius. Oh, I feel it. It's burning. That's a good burn. I know it feels tiring, but don't let them down. You can get stronger. Get stronger in your neck. That feels good. And if you do this, this is called a shoulder shrug. See my shoulders going up? Shoulder shrug. That makes all these muscles here get stronger. Very good, boys and girls. All right, so we did this small, and we did the big arm circles and the small arm circles. Okay, next one, we've done this before. Okay, our frog squat to frog hop. Now remember, when we squat down, we want to try to get our back straight up and our heels are off the ground. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. So you gotta squat down all the way. 4, 5, 6. I'm not bending over. 7. I'm squatting down. 8, 9, and 10. All right, we've done the frog squats. Now, next up, now I have a new one. All right, this is called the lateral walking push-up. Okay, now I like this. We haven't done this yet. So, now this one, got to make sure we do our form correctly. So remember, arms are straight up and down. A lot of you guys are doing this and your hands aren't straight up and down. Look, see my arms are straight up and down. Okay, so you do your push-up and then you walk and walk. See? And push up and then walk and walk. Push up, and then we'll walk and walk. And push up, and then we'll walk and walk. And push up, and then we'll walk and walk. And push up, and we'll walk and walk. Push up, walk and walk. Your feet are always together. Push up. My arms are always straight down underneath. So I may have to readjust my body. That's okay. See what I do? I reposition my hands and my feet so they're straight up and down. Walk and walk. And then down and up. So it's called the lateral walking push-up. All right? That's a real good one. So I definitely build, again, the deltoid muscles, your pectoralis chest muscles, and your triceps, okay? All right, so the next one now is gonna be the our plyo lunge. And we haven't done that for a little while. All right, so now we're gonna do our plyo lunge. Okay, so remember, start down on one knee. I'm gonna do a quick little hop, and you should only have one hand down to keep your balance, but rest of the time, your knees don't touch. 3, 2, 1, and go. And 1, 2. Now, just like doing the frog squat to hop, this is building your ham, your quadriceps, your calf muscles, strengthening your ankles and your balance and your agility. Plus it's a plyometric jump training, raises your heart rate levels, strengthens your lungs, and it strengthens your glutes. So this is a really good exercise. All right, so next up is going to be our sit-ups. All right, our standard sit-ups, back over here. And remember, when we're doing our sit-ups, you want your knees nice and high, okay? And you can have your back a little bit curved. You don't need to have your head on the ground. All right, 3, 2, 1, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, that's enough sit-ups for now. So 15, if you could do more, do more. But we'll just stop at 15 for now because we're going to run out of time. All right, next one. Now I found this one. This will be fun. This is called the lateral bear crawl. So when you're doing the bear crawl, it's kind of like doing a plank where you got to hold yourself up. But now we're going to move around. So we're going to be up on our toes and we're going to do the bear crawl. So this is the bear crawl, if you guys don't know. So we're going to move back and forth. So it strengthens your arms and your shoulders and your chest. So we're going to do the bear crawl. See, boys and girls? So lateral is sideways. So this is the lateral bear crawl. And then we'll crawl forward. And we'll crawl to the side, lateral. And we'll crawl backwards. And as you keep yourself doing this, just get your heart rate going. It strengthens your core, all your core muscles to hold yourself up. It strengthens your arms and chest. And it strengthens your legs too. All right, so that's called the lateral bear crawl. All right, next one we're gonna do is called the crab walk. All right, so the crab walk is the last one, and this is fun, we haven't done this yet. So the crab walk, this strengthens your wrists, the back of your arms, and your core, because you gotta lift it up. So here we go with the crab walk. See, then we'll go sideways, lateral, and then we'll walk backwards, and we'll go sideways, And so the crab walk, you have to keep your body off the ground. And so this is really fun doing the crab walk. And if you can, try to lift your body up higher. But again, crab walk, here's trying not to let the body hit the ground. All right, there you have it, boys and girls. So that'll be the end of week 11, kindergarten through second. And I'll see you at soon or at school. Bye-bye.